And welcome to Roseplay Presents, episode 52, the press conference for Bethesda 2018 at E3. Boy, I said those words all the way around wrong. As always, we're your co-hosts, Orion Moonrose and Saul Wildfire. So it's the third press conference, and boy, do they just seem to be long. Nothing wrong with that, though. So, here on Roseplay Presents, we do things a little differently. Instead of having seasons, we just have episodes, like a special episode. So consider it like your favorite TV show, having like a special 1 hour or hour and a half movie TV made. Or, hey, we're famous enough, we got a movie. We can focus on anything here from interviews with content creators and developers, closed betas, which, yes, I do realize we haven't had a closed beta in, like, oh, God, 20 episodes, 30, I don't know. Press conferences, which is what this is today. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and get started with Bethesda E3 2018. And I gotta go back a second, too. Or, you know, just completely fail miserably. There we go. Lower that a bit.
He's ready?
That's good enough. All right, so
we come from different backgrounds.
Is that they actually show
from different countries.
Bethesda.
We have different interests.
What people do.
In different points of view. We aren't all developers.
Except
it takes all of us. Every one of us to make these games. A job we take very seriously.
I'm not sure who would actually be doing that in real life.
We try and break things and fix things that are broken.
Which is usually a lot
we keep
of,
the teams happy
games.
And fed. We keep our fans
honestly,
happy.
They have a lot of broken games. They do fix them eventually.
And on the edge of their seats.
You know, props to that. They work on it. They don't leave it. But
we keep the books balanced.
Like
discover
Elder
new
Scrolls,
talent. And
yeah,
interact with our community. Most of all, we work together as old friends.
Yeah, usually. I think the only major time.
What unites us is our passion
they
for games.
Really bad was New Day.
Games
like,
as diverse as the people who make them and play them.
It all the way, but there was
we're not just living the dream.
That would,
we're creating
the
it.
We
are all.
Data.
Bethesda Softworks, how may I direct your call?
Just, yeah.
Mm-hmm. You can start the show.
Don't even hear about my personal one. But come on. I want to hear about the time you got that choice. Oh, my God. But that would be bad. Yo.
And now, please welcome Bethesda's Global Senior Vice President, Pete Hines.
Hey, I guess we're going to show your product. Actually, I don't know. What's even on?
Thank you guys very much. You sound good. I love you too.
Oh,
you look
right.
good.
I remember
you guys ready to go?
I think he's wearing some
As Paula said, my name is Pete Hines, and I'm delighted to be back on stage for Bethesda's fourth annual E3 Showcase. Now, we've got all kinds of surprises in store for you tonight, so whether you're here with us in the audience or you're one of the millions who are watching around the world, settle in, get ready for the very best in gaming.
Well,
our theme this year is Create, and it's a theme embraced by our 10 studios spread around the globe, the incredibly talented folks who make the Bethesda games that you'll soon be playing. But as you saw in our intro video, it's not just developers. Everyone at Bethesda is a part of the team that brings our games to life, and that extends to all of you, because we create the worlds, but you create your own adventures, stories, and experiences, and it's your passion for games that drives us every day to strive for excellence. The past year has been an exciting one for Bethesda as we released some of the best games of 2017. Games like Prey, Dishonored: Death of the Outsider, The Evil Within 2, Wolfenstein 2.
That one I was going to go
on. We even released exciting updates for The Elder Scrolls Online. We brought full open world VR with Fallout 4 and Skyrim, plus Doom VFR. And we even released our first two games for the Nintendo Switch. So we were thrilled when Metacritic named us the top publisher in the industry with the highest overall review scores across all of our games. But tonight is about the future. We're here to show you where we're headed and the games that we're creating that you'll soon be playing, the worlds that you'll be inhabiting in the next year and beyond. So, we're starting with a game that we announced a few weeks ago through our friends at Walmart Canada.
Yeah, everybody knows about that.
Perhaps best known for their low prices and ability to keep a secret. So let's get things started with a look at Rage 2.
For whatever reason. So a few weeks prior to E3, Walmart Canada accidentally leaked every E3 game for pre-order. And at the time of that, again, I didn't think he was alive.
Are you ready to rage?
Your life is over now. Your life is running out. When your time is at an end, then it's time to kill again. We can win for this life. I know they were just like, oh, we're running out of things to record. Oh, yeah, ADHD people are like,
I know that guy is wild. And have him rocking out and doing the song and then playing and then showing stuff to it. I think that would work a lot better.
Let's give it up again for Andrew WK, the perfect song for Rage 2.
Because he's such a mess.
Hi, everyone. My name is Tim Willits, and I am the studio director at id Software.
Right. And I'm Magnus Nepfors, game director at Adler Studios.
I doubt if he does.
And we're here to say that Rage is back.
Maybe even remember.
Now, we had a ton of crazy ideas when we started planning Rage 2. And we needed the right studio to bring our vision to life. Now, we've admired the open world chaos in all of Avalanche Studios' games. And as we're about to show you, they delivered big time.
How do you play this game? You hook yourself into it with an IV. And unless you're raging,
well, thank you,
your health goes down. So in other words, by the end of the game, I'm going to have a heart attack.
Yeah.
That is nice to know.
Well, speaking for everyone at Avalanche Studios,
that guy is tall.
This is really a dream to come true for us.
Complete opposite
the world
of
Rage 2 is perfect for our style
of
game.
The other guy's short.
But even more exciting than that has been to work with these guys at id Software. These guys invented the first-person shooter. And they still make the best shooters out there. So it's been a really great collaboration to bring you the most insane open-world shooter you have ever played.
And one's like pretty much
so Rage 2 transports players into a dystopian future, devoid of society, law, and order. Now you play as Walker, the last ranger of the wasteland. Now, you know, I can talk all night about our guns, the powers you'll use, the vehicle combat, and of course, you know, the crazy open world. But I know that you are here to see the game.
Well, it's the audience.
Well, not only do we have Rage 2 playable at our booth at E3, but we've got for you an extended look at the world and gameplay of Rage 2. Let's check it out right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Asteroid on a collision course with Earth. Global extinction event.
80% of the Earth's population dead.
Oh, 80%.
God turned his back on humanity long ago. It wasn't a war. It wasn't global warming. It was a fucking asteroid. I was born in this shithole. Parents murdered,
I'm sorry.
An orphan of this wasteland. An army of mutants killed everyone I ever loved.
Yeah, Bethesda, wow.
All that's left is hate,
what looks like.
Fear, and the need for survival.
Bethesda sure likes their,
You see, part of growing up was watching everything get taken from me. I stood by, did nothing. And now,
I'm the last ranger of this wasteland, and there's only one thing left to do!
Again!
Some guy walks up. Time to rage.
Hello, E3,
rage
and welcome
too.
To the world of Rage 2. In a moment, we'll dive headfirst into the Eden spaceport mission, where Walker, our main protagonist, is out to find a rare artifact that will aid him in his quest to take down the Authority.
Now, it's cool that if you see it, you can drive it. I do like it.
Doctor, I'm approaching the Eden Space Center.
Ah, yes, I forgot to say. It might be overrun by bandits. The Goon Squad, to be precise. You must likely slay them first before pulling down the eco pod from orbit and securing the
Authority. I'm going to transform her out of space. Oh, no, that's fine.
Doctor, made it to the Space Center.
What do you mean by...
Keep your wits about you, Walker. The Goon Squad may look whimsical, laughable even, but believe me, behind their playful appearance, they are very, very
upper
dangerous.
Ten? I don't know what grenade type of grenade that is, but I want one of them. Especially considering the result of that guy floating to one. I don't know, it's almost like you kind of want to play Raid. A little bit.
It sings.
Rocket, rocket, singing songs to the...
I love how he looks at the TV and it starts
with motion sensor activated. Is the Rocket the Crusher talking acting? And it can be yours wild and black. Rage.
He's like, no, I don't know. Yeah, he's a ranger and his name is Walker. That seems like they quit trying. It seems like this cat is turning. Goodbye.
Clear your way to the EcoPod mission control of the third floor.
Present. Threat has been nullified. Mr. President, welcome
made
to
it
our
dark.
EcoPod mission.
Nope. Excellent. Now, look for the central computer. You will initiate the recall procedure for Eco-15. Still in orbit.
Recall sequence approved. Beginning EcoPod recall.
The EcoPod made it.
I know, and so does the Authority. Hurry, get the untainted nanotrites and get out. Also for you, there is an extra boon. Something that will make you a veritable superhero.
Elevator's still running. So far, so good. Looks like Ranger Walker's gonna get a bit of a boost today.
Well, didn't this game remind you of Borderlands?
It makes
you wonder if it's actually taking place on Earth.
Oh, hell yeah!
It does. It looks like Team Kong, or if it's Evil Meteor, he only has that form and starts drooling out of the mouth. There is a lot of crazy action. Well, I guess spring 2019 gives us plenty of time to try out the first one.
From Bethesda Softworks, Christian Van Hoos.
Is there anything in that bag down there?
How's it going, everybody? So. I'm Christian Van Hoos, Community Manager for the Elder Scrolls Legends. For the past year, we have taken what I think is the best digital card game and made it even better. New cards, new modes, new ways to play, and much
card
more.
Card game action!
But we wanted to push ourselves even further. So tonight, I'm thrilled to announce that we will soon be relaunching the Elder Scrolls Legends with brand new, totally overhauled visuals. I'm also very excited to let you all know that Legends will be available later this year on Nintendo Switch, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4.
Now, if only being a Fallout card game.
But there's no reason to wait to play the game that Apple awarded Best of the Year in 2017. Download the Elder Scrolls Legends for free and join me tonight on PC, mobile, or tablet. And any progress you make in the game will be carried over to the console versions through your BethesdaNet account.
They did, that too.
And now, let's take a look at the future of Legends and see why this isn't just my favorite card game, but will soon be yours as well.
You're expecting too much.
It starts small. One game is all it takes. But Legends never stay simple. Never stay small. This is action. This is story. This is competition. This is easy to pick up. This is hard to put down.
Well, one, they're not really showing enough to try to pick up.
This is a 5-minute train ride. This is a 5-hour marathon. This is for any way you play. This is for anywhere you play. This is for strategy fans. This is for those who want magic at their fingertips. This is for those who want dragons at their command.
Or, you know,
this is a game where legends are born. This is for you.
I don't know, they really didn't show much. If they're trying to get people to be involved in it, they need a better trailer.
From ZeniMax Online Studios, Matt.
Elder Scrolls card game.
Thank you.
Hi, Gregory.
Thanks, everyone. I'm Matt Fyroar. I'm the game director on the Elder Scrolls Online. Thank you. Before I get started tonight, I just want to do a shout out. It was really great. We started the showcase tonight with the video highlighting the really talented people that work behind the scenes to make all of these great games possible.
I think that one could work.
So standing here on stage, I'm representing a whole lot of amazing people at ZeniMax Online Studios that I go to work with every day. It's a great honor and privilege.
Because I mean, the game's already created.
I go to work with them every day, but at night I go home, log into Elder Scrolls Online, and I get to play games with you guys, the best gaming community in online gaming. We are such big fans of what we do. We play the games just as, you know, we make them, and we play them just as much as you guys do. It's what we do. You know, so you might not know it, but we're right there alongside. I'm playing there with you. I'm running dungeons. I'm exploring Tamriel, questing, crafting, decorating my house, PvPing, stabbing. Yeah, that was me.
But I would rather, again, see
and
a Fallout.
I'm really humbled to say that the Elder Scrolls Online community just keeps getting bigger. We're over 11 million players now.
I don't know Elder Scrolls at all,
really. Well, we did buy number 5.
And over a million of those came in just the last year alone.
And the only building we have to worry about is one of the DLCs.
So last year was really great for us in a whole lot of ways. We were named MMO of the year for the third straight year.
Fallout
in the evil time. We released Morrowind. A lot of great DLC, and just last week we released Somerset, the latest chapter in the Elder Scrolls Online.
Fan of MMO.
It's been you know, received with great critical acclaim. But everyone loves it. You get to travel to the island home of the High Elves for the first time in 20 years. It's great for new players. If in the off chance you aren't playing Elder Scrolls Online, this is a great chance to jump in and play. And of course, all you veteran ESO fans are already there.
Class choices.
But we're not done there. We make DLC every quarter for chapters. You know, content comes out so regularly for Elder Scrolls Online. We're already working on our great plans for next year.
I feel like they're more play,
but before that,
pay to win,
the next
play
DLC coming out is a dungeon DLC named Wolf Hunter, based on werewolves. And later this year, we have a story DLC named Murkmire. We're going back to Black Marsh. So you guys have all been asking for a deeper dive into Argonian lore and culture. You're going
to
see it later this year.
Werewolf, and you have the option to kill it or keep it. You don't transform at will, though.
So there's one theme that runs through all of the Elder Scrolls Online's content, and that is great storytelling. From the launch game through all the DLC and chapters, it's really, really what holds the game together. But it's not just the stories that we as developers create for you guys to experience. It's also the stories that you create together when you play this great virtual world. So I'm going to leave you tonight with a video highlighting just some of the amazing stories and memorable characters that you'll meet on your ESO journey. Thanks, everyone. See you in Tamriel.
Is anyone like you can transform or not transform, go back and forth between a dog and a person on some games like Dead to Rights?
See, even though it was story mode, I liked The Wolf Among Us. For that. I mean, you could transform if you got angry, but you could control it. They are doing a season 2 of that, so I'm not actually surprised by that. But I'm just excited about anything Telltale, so. See, I mean, literally, this is a little bit of Elder Scrolls. Minus more online, but I mean, it's pretty much kind of how the Elder Scrolls plays in general. Because you can have to go into third person and first person. Even though, let's be honest, even though it looks medieval, sometimes it also looks like a post-apocalyptic medieval. Yeah. You could be a cat and play with yourself. Now, the cats are Khajiit. They're actually a class that you can play in the game. There's orcs, there's the Khajiit, the elves, there's even offspring. Well, they look kind of dumb. And now I'm probably going to get slapped on.
Whoa, those are so and so, they're great class.
Everyone can see it. In Elder Scrolls, it's only for the fact that night vision. I did a night
vision. Dragon Age.
Dragon Age 4. Wait, is this Elder Scrolls 6? No. Like Rage 2? I can't tell the difference between our games anymore, guys. Well, that's horrible. They start making so many post-apocalyptic games that they don't even know what they're doing. To be fair, I had a pretty good idea what this one was for the game.
Elder Age Inquisition.
Elder Rage Inquisition.
Elder Rage.
I'd play that. See, I wasn't for sure if it was or not, but I'm like, well, this looks post-apocalyptic, but it looks like hell. I'm going to say it's a sequel to Doom. My cat had worms, and it caused Armageddon. And they said animals weren't the devil. Oh wait, that was just somebody's name. I don't know. I really want to play Doom. I really like how the first one is.
Thanks so much. I'm Marty Stratton, executive producer of Doom Eternal.
And I'm Hugo Martin, creative director on Doom Eternal.
Yeah. Is he really nervous?
Or in 2016, really we launched our reboot of Doom and have been blown away by your support and excitement for the game. Thank you. In fact, it's a combination of your passion and our team's love of making Doom that has motivated us to deliver even more.
So we're back to announce Doom Eternal.
I think he is trying too hard.
An awesome new sequel to Doom. For the past 2 years, it's been so inspiring to hear you guys talk about what you'd like to see next. And I got to tell you, we're right there with you. Like, you want the Doom Slayer to feel even more powerful? Well, we got it. You want even more badass demons?
You know,
well, there are twice as many in this game. You want to see Hell on Earth?
They're making a movie about a
we just teased it. But what we're most excited about is to show you some of the things that you might not be expecting.
That's right, including a ton of features that we'll have to save for later because our team will be debuting Doom Eternal at QuakeCon this August. We'd love for you to join us live in Dallas, or of course you can tune in online to catch all the fun. But until then, we want to thank everyone who continues to play Doom.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you.
And I knew it just was right away. I knew it was Quake.
How's everybody feeling tonight? Pretty hype?
Quake.
Just like a little hype or like crazy hype right now, right? Let's go. Thanks. Hi. I'm Joshua Boyle, community manager for Quake Champions.
Even though I kind of wanted to say.
Thank you very much. Ever since the first Quake title was released in 1996, our games have been shaped by you, the players.
I kind of had to.
Now that proud tradition continues with Quake Champions, which has evolved with community in mind. And will always be the fastest and most fun multiplayer shooter, period.
When you play something superior, the other thing looks bad.
And that's not the only tradition that Quake's continuing. These days, we're hearing a lot of talk about esports, but Quake has been there from the very beginning.
Yeah, Quake was almost the start of esports.
We started hosting competitions at QuakeCon over 20 years ago. It's here for QuakeCon. And this year, we'll expand on our legacy as the original esport with everything from intense grassroots competitions to major tournaments at QuakeCon and DreamHack Winter.
Does he got a rat tail?
I think it's a ponytail.
We've been doing this for a long time, and we're continuing to build with more competitions for more players than ever before.
I don't know, it looks like it's almost on both sides.
Maybe he was just trying
but
to
I gotta tell you guys, we can't stop, won't stop until we've delivered a game that's fun for everyone, whether you're a Quake dad or a brand new baby to the arena. That's why we just added a bunch of new features to make it even easier for you and your friends to jump in and get good together.
No, I think it's Quake, but he's got a Q on.
Oh, really? It's Quake? It looks like.
We're still in early access, maybe, really, but tonight we want to welcome to all of you into the arena.
But they moved too fast.
For this week only, we're opening up Quake Champions to everyone through a trial of our free-to-play version before it even launches. Plus, if you get in and download this week, you can stay and keep playing Quake Champions for free even after the trial closes.
So, like, are they literally just going to let you play Quake then?
So head to Quake.com and start playing with me and all of my Quake family tonight.
I mean, that's kind of cool. Hey, we have a free beta that you can play.
Don't miss your chance to join one of the most passionate and welcoming communities in gaming. Now, for a taste of what you'll be playing tonight after our showcase is over, check out our new trailer for Quake Champions.
Yeah, no, I don't know. I don't know about the hair or the shirt.
3, 2.
What is gonna say I should really pop on the back of the shirt?
You're tasty. We'll find out how tasty soon.
Yeah.
The bigger the guns, the
bigger. It feels like a lot of those shooters, like, over exaggerate themselves a lot. There's high colors, crazy. Bad end.
I'm still gonna flip you like a table.
I like, and then Paladin
pretty much just bugging out. Yeah. Now, see, don't get me wrong. I'm alright with game stealing from up to a certain extent. I mean, technically, think about it. That's how a lot of people crack Bandicoot, kind of thing, Mario, Spyro kind of thing, crack, and that kind of thing, company. Most RPGs came from Final Fantasy. So you're right, yeah, it's changing up. And I do think that Paladin, at least in the beginning, did change it up. I feel like they have kind of slumped back into Overwatch a little bit, but you still got the card system. Things are a little... Yeah, if you make a few different originalities, you can just be like, hey, we're just following your formula.
Hello, E3, from all of us at Arcane Studios here in Austin, Texas. It's been 1 year since we launched Prey, and we want to send a big thanks to our incredible fan base for your support.
We've been so inspired by your passion and enthusiasm, and as a way of showing our appreciation, we're rolling out a huge free update for Prey tonight.
The next time you fire up Prey, you're going to see three new modes. Story mode, New Game Plus,
which was a big fan request,
and Survival mode, which should be an interesting challenge for our most hardcore fans.
But that's just the beginning. We are really excited to tell everyone that we've also been working on a new Prey DLC.
I think
an infinitely replayable experience called Moon Crash.
It's a new twist on Prey where the enemies, hazards, and loot are all different each time you play.
We're so excited. We can't wait to what?
I know, I love that they were trying.
The moon is a harsh
mistress. At least they were trying.
The longer you're here,
it's better than
the
just
harder
coming
things
out of the
are going to get for
game,
you.
Doing a little gameplay.
Let's get
and going
to work. The moon harsh mistress. Let's get to work.
I really wish they would have just had the song play.
Technically already
aliens. Yeah. Well, I mean, at least Halo 1 through 3 were aliens and slugs. 4 were, like, robots? 5, 2, I think? Maybe.
And electrical damage detected. Lethal radiation levels detected.
Probably.
Check your hand,
now will be copyrighted for this. Hold it a second, we'll probably be you. Well, got one copyright claim. It was all of itself, that never can happen. Our Microsoft Press Conference got 9 copyrights.
Let's get to work.
Nothing bad. You know, they still have to play the video. It's just any money that's made from the video goes to them. Which, joke on them, I'm not getting any money off the press conferences. But...
All right, before we begin, yes, Mom, I'm still alive. No, I'm not a mimic.
Hang on.
So for those of you who probably there. Couldn't hear us, I don't know.
I just want to make sure nobody tries to smack you because I saw Pete Hines with a wrench backstage a second ago.
Thank you, Ricardo. That's very sweet of you.
Like
all arcade games, Prey is about playing your own way, and Moon Crash is no exception.
So you just saw a lot of cool stuff that's available tonight, but we're not done yet. We have one more surprise coming later this summer called Typhon Hunter.
Typhon Hunter is a lethal game of hide-and-seek, where one player goes head-to-head against 5 other players who get to be mimics.
And just like in Prey, the mimic players can disguise themselves as everyday objects. So,
it's dead by
you know,
daylight.
Things like a chair, a coffee mug, a space banana,
so it's
whatever
dead
works.
By
but
mixed
definitely
with,
not a co-worker. Right, Susan?
Absolutely not.
See, at least
they're
funny little
kids.
I give
them no! Anyway, Typhon Hunter is a tense multiplayer mode that requires teamwork and improvisation and a very high tolerance for jump scares.
Before we go, I just want to say thanks on behalf of the whole team at Arcane Studios to all of our fans around the world who have played Prey and love it. We made this game for you, and we are constantly inspired by your creativity and enthusiasm.
Hey, thank you so much, everyone.
A lot of companies are like, the game's out, we're done, go away, people.
Please welcome Jens Matthies.
And
Jens
right away,
Gustafsson.
I knew it was Wolfenstein, too. I'm like, oh, they're doing more DLC for Wolfenstein. And then they went to the old Blood play.
Hello, nice. Friends. I'm Jens Matthies, the creative director at Machine Games.
You went the old Blood way, but different.
And I'm Jarkko Gustafsson, executive producer at Machine Games.
I think we're going to play it with the one simple fact, which they haven't announced.
Last year, millions of you took to the streets and sparked a revolution in Wolfenstein 2, the new Colossus.
You probably beat the crap out of Hitler.
As BJ Blazkowicz, you rallied the American resistance. And you beat the living fuck out of those Nazis.
I feel somebody doesn't like Nazis a lot.
Thank you for embracing our game. We were honored to win Best Action Game at the Game Awards last December.
You know, but
and we are excited to bring Wolfenstein 2 to Nintendo Switch on June 29th, so you can fight the Nazis on the go.
Yeah. And the Wolfenstein Revolution continues with our next project, which leaps ahead in time to tell the tale of BJ's twin daughters. Set in the 1980s in Paris, Wolfenstein Youngblood pushes the story forward.
I don't even know.
Because this game features BJ's twin daughters, Wolfenstein Youngblood will be a co-op experience.
See, when I was going to school, it was a very weird time. We were in a transition phase.
So while you can play it solo, you can also join with a friend to save the world together. The resistance is counting on you.
All of a sudden, it wasn't.
So all right, Hollyboss, let's check it out.
Cursive or not? And then they were just like, nah, screw it. Because, like I said, it was that time of how old I was. And
listen, children. I've been fighting all my life for this world. It never ends.
Fallout now?
They're gonna send everything they have at you.
Actually, that line will be perfect.
To survive, you have to embrace the suffering. To stand up and carry it. It's not about the pain you can deal. It's about how much you can take.
It's do or die, sis. Just like Papa taught us.
How's it coming, 2019? Somebody coughed. Yeah, somebody coughed.
Hi.
I think it was the camera guy.
Hi. At Bethesda, we're proud of our history of innovation, and that includes breakthrough VR technology that we revealed at E3 2012. Since then, we've delivered some of the very best VR experiences in gaming,
so
from
really like
Doom to Fallout 4 to Skyrim, and we're not done.
And two people attack.
Two of the franchises that we just heard about are going to also offer VR experiences. So, when Prey's Typhon Hunter is released later this summer, you'll be able to experience the competitive mode that Susan and Ricardo were just talking about in virtual reality. And it will also include a single-player experience that puts you in the boots of TransStar employees working to solve puzzles aboard the Talos One space station.
With you especially.
I'm also excited to announce a new Wolfenstein VR game. It's called Wolfenstein Cyberpilot, in which you play a hacker who can take over Nazi robots and turn these war machines against their masters. And our ever-ending quest to bring the message of fuck Nazis to every platform possible.
I think all of us have just literally hate a bunch of zombies. Which, to be fair, there were Nazi zombies in the old one.
Both the Prey and Wolfenstein VR experiences are playable this week at our booth at E3, so please stop by and give them a try. Now, we are really excited about everything that we've shown here tonight, but I know there are a lot of you who are really here or really wondering about Fallout 76.
Oh no, this is it.
And I'm pleased to tell you that your wait is finally over. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the recipient of numerous Lifetime Achievement and Hall of Fame awards. He's the game director at a studio that has won a bevy of accolades and awards. And he's here tonight to tell us what he and his team have been taking so damn long to tell us all about. Will you please welcome my very good friend, Mr. Todd Howard.
I know. 3 for 3. We've had 3 press conferences and every one of them. But why wouldn't you Fallout 7? Fallout in general is like super uber everywhere.
We're all here. Looking good. Oh, it's great to be back at E3. Thank you. Thank you so much. I could not be more excited to be here. I want to thank all our fans who came out tonight. And the millions of you watching online. We can't thank you enough. This is actually my 25th year at Bethesda. And I have seen...
Again, I will say, you look extremely good.
I have seen
age.
A lot of cool things in that time. I got to say, tonight is definitely one of them. I got to go to the very first E3 right here in Los Angeles. I know. They're so cute when they're little. They're full of energy and life. And then, remember when little E3 ran away from home, went to Atlanta? Yes. A lot of you didn't come. I liked Atlanta. Or East Coast. And then E3 went through the moody teen years and came back and locked itself in its room. Remember, it was in the convention center, but just in the meeting rooms. They didn't invite anybody. And I can remember literally walking between the halls and seeing nobody. I was like, this is how a zombie movie starts. And now E3 has grown up, it's in its 20s, it's more confident, can handle its alcohol better, like all of you. Thank you.
We're gonna get you all drunk by the end of the night.
So there's a good party after this, so pace yourselves.
See?
And I hope you're comfortable, by the way. I'm gonna be here for a while. And E3 has become such an incredible week of entertainment.
Yeah, I'm really glad
that
we
know
the back up to E3.
That most of you came here for one thing.
Todd Howard!
Thank you.
Todd Howard. Or really respect him for his games. Yeah. Look at him though, he's kind of.
I think it's to see where we're putting Skyrim
he's
next.
Like, yeah, he's like proud of himself. It's funny he said he's out. You came here for me.
Well, I think we have the best one yet.
The Elder Scrolls speak of the past and the future. Now, Skyrim looks to the future, to its ultimate version.
Alexa, play Skyrim.
You're level 57 and see a tall snowy mountain.
Climb it. Now, Skyrim and life become one.
A mud crab scuttles towards
first
you.
Roda.
I didn't catch that.
First Roda!
I didn't quite catch that.
First Roda!
Your shout echoes all the way to Sovngarde.
What happened?
First Roda.
I
the command
have
for
to divorce him
knocking things
point.
Over.
Yeah, is there a command for thing. Picking shit up?
Haven't reached that level yet.
I'm sworn to carry your burdens.
Well, you better reach that level.
Or else you're gonna
the dragon
lose
unleashes fire breath on you.
Okay.
You have 7% health left.
Oh, shit. I drink a health potion.
You are out of health potions.
How many wheels of cheese do I have left?
473.
Okay, I eat all the cheese.
Hey, hon. Remember what the doctor said about dairy.
Yes, right, yes, of course. You're the greatest. Thank you so much. I eat all of the cheese.
Introducing Skyrim, very special edition. Also coming soon to Etch-A-Sketch. Motorola pagers.
Oh, shit.
And your Samsung smart refrigerator.
East Slend Noose.
Oh, that's cool.
I'm sorry, that's probably gotta be the best part of. I'm almost gonna say all of
these words. Had to do it. Okay, really, we both know why you're here, and that's to talk about
the Samsung
the next
fridge
Fallout.
That can play and drop ice everywhere.
Fallout 76 is a prequel to all the other games. And it's our biggest one yet. It is 4 times the size of Fallout 4. Set in the hills of West Virginia, you are one of the first to emerge into an untamed and very different wasteland.
That you'll get the third call. Well, I'm screwed. At least it's pretty. Look at that beautiful cloud of- Oh god, it burns! I didn't get that last time. It literally- Oh god-
Yeah. 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you. So that if the bombs do come, our way of life will endure.
Hey, all right.
almost heaven. West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is all there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains.
I feel like I've seen this trailer way too many times, even before E3. And I'm going to skip ahead.
So when the fighting is stopped,
because
and the fallout has settled,
how does the suit survive?
You must rebuild.
But the insides are nothing.
Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. Country roads, take me home. Vault 76, our future begins.
Without you.
Vault 76, one of the very first vaults to open, was built to celebrate America's tercentenary, which is an awesome word, by the way. Like, that's your word of the night. Tercentenary. You are one of the very special few selected to be an occupant and spend 25 years underground waiting for Reclamation Day, the day the vault opens.
Oh, maybe it is that.
I think he was just saying it wrong.
Maybe.
Good morning, Vault 76.
I remember at this point, you were like, they need to show gameplay footage. And I was like, yes, they do.
I hope you all
and
enjoyed
they
the party
did follow through
night.
With it, though. At
Even
first, we were like, that wasn't as much as we were
overindulged
hoping.
And overslept, but it's time to get up and get out there. We've been locked away long enough.
Now, if I'm correct, none of the vaults were supposed to open up till 2100 or 2200.
Today
so the fact that this does take place in 2076 explains why there were people in the world again.
Finally! I feared you'd never wake up. Don't you remember? Time to leave the vault! Most of
yeah, no, I think it's safer here. I'm going back to bed
now. It may be time to leave, but I'll never forget the day you all entered Vault 76. You come from every walk
We're
of life,
the
every
of
race,
place.
Color, and creed.
There's nobody
but you
left.
All share
exactly.
One very important trait. You are this country's best
yeah,
and brightest.
Right?
But more importantly, you'll always be my family.
Goodbye! Aloha! Ciao!
To be fair, though, if they left early or something, there's still food left over. Yeah, with one person, you think the vault's supposed to hold hundreds of people, hundreds of thousands? You could definitely, yeah, live off of it the rest of your life. Or just go outside every
we
so
always
often
start
kill
with the
a
world.
Rat.
And this time it
rat,
features
it
all
back.
New rendering, lighting, and landscape technology. It allows us to have 16 times the detail and even view distant weather systems across the map. Now, most people don't know West Virginia that well. It is an incredible array of natural wonders, towns, and government secrets. This is where the actual nuclear secrets are. And the quest the Overseer sends you on will take you through 6 distinct regions, each with their own style, risks, and rewards.
Why I don't know.
There's plenty of cool new Fallout creatures, and we even use the folklore of West Virginia to bring our Fallout versions to life.
You kid bullfrog! Yeah, apparently the wind's an enemy now, too.
We have always wanted to tell that story of what it would be like for you and the other characters who were first to leave the vaults. But there is one big difference with this game. It's that each of those characters is a real person.
And I love at that point, you were like, I know you got
because
questions.
Yes, Fallout 76 is entirely
them.
Online.
I don't okay. know. I always felt like Fallout.
I know. There's a lot. You have like 1,000 questions right now.
And here it is.
So yep. I'm going to go through them in order. Now, I'll hit a couple of the big ones. First, of course,
yeah,
you can
they're
play
like
this.
Player, and they're like, nope, I'm done right? with Fallout.
You'll,
I want nothing to do with it.
You'll be who you want, exploring a huge world, doing quests, experiencing a story, and leveling up. We love those things about our games,
see,
too, and would not
player,
have it
though,
any other way.
And I mean,
but
it's
also,
the first
like
there's
many
first
of you, we
go
have always wanted
vault.
To see
of
what our style of game
people.
Could be with
the
multiplayer.
Rest of the took place like
so many of us talk
this event.
About experiences in our games, but we've never experienced them together. So about 4 years ago, we hit upon an idea that is perfect for Fallout. Open world, survival, every person and character is real. And it was an idea
though,
that we just
wonder,
couldn't shake.
If you are playing single
we
player,
knew we had to
and
do it
is,
and do it in a really big way.
You know, if there is
now,
no
I know
players,
you may have
obviously.
Played survival
Does
modes in like some of our previous games or some other online games. And we, you know, people
is
wonder, is this hardcore survival?
Survive the blast,
I like to think of it
giants,
maybe
whatnot, you
it's
know,
more
cool.
softcore survival.
I don't know, but see a lot of people like that.
Maybe that should be a new ESRB descriptor.
And now you're just going to go to the
death
who are really
never
cool.
means the loss of progression.
Well,
or the
I still
loss
think
of
there
your
will be
character.
A lot of talking to people. Like
your
said,
character isn't
whatnot,
tied
like that,
to one that. Server.
But
as a matter of fact, you'll
that.
Never
I mean,
even see
a
server
a lot
when you
of
play.
Choices in my conversation.
You'll be in a world with dozens, not hundreds, and not thousands of
and
other players. It's the apocalypse. It's not an amusement park, okay? And you'll be able to join your friends whenever you want, and all of your progression goes with you. When we think about
oh, yeah,
games,
definitely.
We think about worlds and the choices that you can make, the stories that you create and tell yourself. By creating a wide open world with very few rules, we have a game more than any game that we've ever done where the choices are yours, where you'll decide what happens. You'll decide the heroes and you'll decide the villains. Look, this is a whole new
I mean,
world for all of us
it,
here.
And
fortunately, our friends at Vault-Tec
okay.
have made a series of informational videos
and
for
I
when all of us emerge together.
The vault. This is the best way to tell
As
anything.
You venture out into this new American frontier, some of your fellow survivors may not be neighborly.
I'm sorry, you might be a little past friendly.
Chin up there, sport. Not all Vault 76
say,
dwellers will be so hostile. Find them and brave the
on.
New world together. Whether you choose to explore the wasteland alone or with friends, your days will be filled with fun activities.
You can run like a rabbit, fly like a bee. No matter what you do, you'll never get away from me. Because
yeah, because that was really going to stop me. Wow. Well, I don't think it would have worked out that well. I do like it, though. Apparently, sloths aren't that tired.
Like previous Fallouts, you can play this game solo in quest. But the easiest way to survive in the wasteland is to team up and build together. And in this one, you can
build
wherever you want.
Like that aspect of the game.
And you can also then move that to wherever you want.
After thermonuclear war, man's towering industrial marvels may no longer stretch to the heavens. What separates man from beasts? It is his desire to build. Get started with camps. The construction and assembly mobile platform. Construct your home of the future. With your home secure, you can now craft handmade ordnance at your leisure to give your altercations that personal touch. It falls on you and the ingenuity of your fellows to rebuild the America we hold dear. But don't
but I agree with what you said, Actually. Well, you're just in passing.
Monitor your environment for anything.
The building is not a bad idea.
The ordinary.
It's a great idea, but it should all be optional. It should be an optional quest. Not a main quest. Not everybody
the
does
home
like
of
to build.
Tomorrow
so
may
go
undergo
whatever the heck
challenges.
That is in the head. Yeah.
After
sorry,
a crisis,
super
work with your neighbors
sound, I
for
not.
Your success. There's
bad,
no I in nuclear wasteland. Document your adventures.
Now,
your memories
right there,
will
though,
shape the new American
cool.
dream. What's that
we
sound?
Killed it. Yeah. We killed it! We killed it!
There goes the neighborhood.
There goes the neighborhood. We got it.
Yeah, we love dynamic game systems. So we thought, why don't we put multiple nuclear missile sites on the map? And then let all of you do whatever you want
okay,
with them.
So, in other words,
today's episode, Atomics for Peace.
We're talking about a game.
When you emerge from the comfort and safety of your vault, the world you know will have changed. Take your friendly old neighbor Johnny. Rather than coming over to borrow a cup of sugar, he may now be coming over for murder. The time has come to seek out greater means of protection. Nuclear armaments. That's right. Courtesy of your Uncle Sam, these wonders of the atomic age can be found right in your own backyard. But how does a fella like you acquire nuclear weapons, you may ask? Begin by inquiring with the locals. Gently coax them into cooperation. Use a little elbow grease if you have to.
I don't know, the nuclear thing seems like a good idea and a bad idea at the same time.
In the likely event you don't acquire
a
full code on your own, do not give up.
I would
search for others who might be harboring a grudge. You'll
or if
have
I was
that
a real
nuclear launch
today.
Code in no time.
Go online just long enough.
The power of the
place,
atom at your fingertips, be responsible and consider your target carefully.
Attention, launch sequence activated.
Yeah, like, what does this show us? That they did not learn their lesson. Hey guys, for the people watching this new version, it's
time
to be new.
Will your bomb land
hey guys,
on a rival camp of degenerates?
From the
a random
like
stranger? The local wildlife? Whatever your target may be, take advantage of the resulting fallout to gather rare and valuable resources.
We're true.
Yet these rewards don't come without risk. The fate of this new world is yours to command with the power of the atom.
What if there's a main mission there? You're not going to survive that week. The radiation will be like...
We know you've played a lot of our games and a lot of online games, but this one really is unique. We have built a platform, 100% dedicated servers that will support this game now and for years to come. And look, we know this is new for all of you. It's new for us. It's a little bit scary. And to that end, we're going to need your help. Because, yes, we are going to have a beta.
War for Peace.
And it is sponsored by our friends at Vault-Tec as well, the Break It Early test application. Because evidently, these online games are hard. They can have some nasty issues. I read on the internet that our games have had a few bugs. I did. I read it on the internet, so it's true. And that sometimes it doesn't just work. Anyway, we know together that we are going to build something really special. And we also know that all of you love our special editions. And we have an awesome collector's edition for you. It starts with a map of the world that glows in the fucking dark.
Come on, no nuking.
It's great.
No nuke in the concrete that way.
So cool.
Really?
It comes with figures you can put on the map. And it also comes with a Fallout collectible that really I've always wanted, so we made them for everybody to buy, and here it is.
Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right.
No, that is awesome, though.
Cool down, Papa,
an
don't you blow your top.
Helmet.
Ain't
with
no
the voice
use
module.
In diving. What's the use of diving? Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Yes, all of this, the Fallout 76
vision,
Power
sold.
Armor Edition.
Yeah.
So you're probably wondering, when is this game coming out? We're excited to say
that
it's coming out this year, November
14th. It doesn't surprise me. Because Fallout and Elder Scrolls seem to always come out in November.
Thanks again for all your support of Fallout. It's been 10 years since Fallout 3, our very first one, and it's been an incredible journey with all of you. We do have another Fallout anniversary that we are celebrating here at E3. It is the 3-year anniversary of Fallout Shelter, which we announced and released right here at E3. And we have some cool surprises for you. Fallout Shelter is coming to the PlayStation 4.
Took it long.
And because
honestly.
That guy said it, it's also coming to the Nintendo Switch.
The Switch has been out for like a year.
You can play it with the Joy-Cons or touch controls. And yes, it's still free.
No, we're going to charge you for the PS4 and the Switch version.
Ooh, so
is
that PlayStation 2?
Alright.
And excited to say these versions are coming out
I get that Switch
tonight.
And hell, right?
Oh, this is wrong.
Again, thank you so much for your support of all that we do coming here tonight. When we see how many of you our games have touched, it's incredibly special. Especially Fallout Shelter. That game has been played by over 120 million people.
Question mark?
Incredible. That is more people than every game that we have made combined. Incredible. It does kind of make you stop and realize that our games can have new lives on any type of device or system. And, you know, when we looked at the iPhone 11 years ago, we had a few ideas for mobile games. Fallout Shelter was one of them. And we did have another one that was far, far more ambitious. And we've been building it. And it's in the other franchise that you love from us. It is called The Elder Scrolls Blades. Like Fallout Shelter, we wanted an experience that we were not finding anywhere else.
I think he says that it is going to come to consoles eventually. Here it is. That's what I will wait for.
Blades, at its heart, is a pure Elder Scrolls game. A massive first-person RPG with console-quality graphics.
My phone,
but with a uniquely mobile experience. Believe me when I say you have to see this running on an iPhone 10. This gigantic screen does not do it justice. You can tap to move or use dual sticks. Combat is all new, and it follows your specific movements and timings.
You probably would have to have either the Galaxy S9 or the Apple X.
Harkening back to the first Elder Scrolls Arena, this game features both handcrafted
and yours would explode.
Procedurally generated dungeons. And it's not just melee. You have a range of abilities and spells you can use. And of course, you can create your own character and be who you want to be. Improving them, leveling up, picking new abilities. And the entire game can be played in portrait mode. That one was incredibly important to us, that you could play it however you wanted. You never know when you'll need a free hand.
Yeah,
to hold your coffee. Let's
come
to
console. It ain't
happening. Degenerates. And it's not just dungeons. It's incredible outdoor areas.
Look at those beautiful graphics.
Yes, running on a phone. It really looks and plays incredible.
Yours will look 8-bit. So Atari. Like Morphin. I don't even know if your phone can handle Minecraft.
Blaze has several modes of play. First, the Abyss, a roguelike experience where you can see how far you can go in an endless dungeon. And the Arena, where you will do battle one-on-one against other players. And the main mode, the Town. This is the hub for your story and quests.
Oh my god.
You are a member of the Blades, the Empire's top agents. Forced in exile, you return home to find your town destroyed and need to rebuild it. Yes, Blades also features a town building mode. You'll decide what your town looks like and be able to upgrade and decorate all of the individual elements in it. As your town levels up, you unlock new NPCs, quests, and more. You can even visit your friends' towns. This.
We see your phone can do the message. We see you download the most beautiful game in the history of phones. Goodbye.
This is an Elder Scrolls game that you can play however and wherever you want. And we are going to bring Blades to every device and system we can. phones, PCs, consoles, also virtual reality, on mobile, all the way up to high-end VR on PCs. And what's really cool is all of those connect to each other. So one of my dreams is we'll go back to that portrait mode, which I like to call meeting mode. Because if you're in a meeting on your playing a game, in portrait mode, no one knows you're playing a game.
Well, on your phone, you're getting fired.
And so with Blades, you could be in a meeting playing Blades against someone at home in VR.
You can see, look at her.
Blades is coming this fall. For free.
I'm checking emails. You have extremely happy females.
And you can pre-order it tonight on both the Apple App Store and the Google Play Store. Also, this week, go to playblades.com and register for early access. If you're here at E3, Blades is going to be playable in our booth. So please, come by and check it out. You really need to see it running on the phone. We'd love to see you. Please come by.
Well, we're sorry our video inconvenienced your game.
I just want to thank you all again, all of our fans here, everybody watching online, for all of your support over the years. It is so exciting to show you all that we have coming out this year. And it is an honor and a blessing to represent all of the incredible people at Bethesda Game Studios. We have three offices now in Maryland, Montreal, and Austin. There's a lot of them here tonight. I want them to hear your appreciation for their work.
Yeah, they all light up there.
Thank you.
It's really weird. It's like wireless. It's how they get their slaves.
Just the best team and group of people I could ever hope for. Amazing. We also thought, since we're all here together tonight and it's so special, maybe we'd do something a little different too.
We're on the show, we're buying everybody
around. And tell you what we have coming beyond this year in the future. We have also been working on a brand new next generation single player game.
Yeah, next generation pretty much means.
But this one is in an all new epic franchise. Yeah. Our first
fully original franchise on Xbox One and PS4.
In 25 years.
I'm not even but you just wait. Maybe a PS5 going on.
Well, some rumors are saying a PS5 and an Xbox 2.
We're excited to announce our next adventure.
So let me get this straight. We got the Xbox 360, the Xbox One, and now the Xbox 2. That makes no sense. One makes sense because when they named the Xbox One and the Xbox One, it was supposed to be because they were trying to bring everything together. Media, gaming, everything. Well, not just that, but it'd be a play in line. It's like, why did you name your system 2? Because the first one was named 1. I do realize you really nice to tell them to say one because they bring everything together. Like, you sit down and do everything on one thing rather than doing something on your phone.
Now there'd be like two because all of our things are not co-op.
You know, if they were doing all co-op, I mean, you wouldn't have to co-op using your phone. But if they would at least have every game co-op in the next gen,
Starfield
that would be very interesting.
Is a game that we have spent years thinking about and working on.
That would be neat.
Something we feel uniquely positioned to pull off and that we're incredibly excited about.
But
we're also building toward the game after
that. With the fact that Xbox is blending in.
And it's the one you keep asking about.
Like, either do one more system and call it quits, or literally just stick to the Xbox One and let it connect to the computer.
this is gonna go on before, like, even after we have
I don't know, I think they're getting close to where they can't do anything new for it, other than VR.
Don't worry, what can we do? All we have to do is really
expand the space. I mean, graphics have improved at least this generation. But, oh, and woo! Elder Scrolls 6! I know at one point in the next is still relevant. Microsoft bought the technology from HoloJet.
Okay, yeah, actually, now I'm really done. I just want to thank you all for your time tonight, the time you've spent in our worlds. We'll see you out there.
Don't get me wrong, I love hearing all about Fallout, but I feel like it went on forever.
Can I get another round of applause, please? Another round of applause, please, for Todd Howard.
Unless you actually got into the theory.
We only get him up here like once every three E3s, but boy, when he shows up, he brings the goods. Thanks also to all of our studios and teams around the world who are so dedicated to giving our fans the very best games. If you're a gamer on any platform of any kind, we think we've got something for you. And I hope you're as excited about what you've seen tonight as we are, whether it's a new Fallout game, a new Elder Scrolls game from Bethesda Game Studios that you can play on your phone for free, Rage 2, Doom Eternal, and so much more. We're really excited. Now, remember, if you want to be one of the first to play Elder Scrolls Blades or join the Fallout 76 beta, you need to go to BethesdaNet and register. It's easy and it's free. For all of you here with us tonight, thank you so much for joining. The party is going to continue afterwards. For everyone else around the world, thank you so much for joining us. Everyone have a good night and a great E3.
Oh, they're kissing. Apparently you were really happy about the conference.
Oh, this went well.
Come get yourself younger. I heard about Elder Scrolls 6. That would be something. Probably go to jail. Probably not even get kicked out.
Yeah,
I know. Exposure. Whatever it is when you're doing it on stage or in public.
My name is...
What an explosion, man. Today was a good day.
Just kidding.
Whenever I hear that line, I always want to say it's today was a good day.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to GameSpot's coverage of E3 2018. That show ended, I don't even know.
Yeah, no, definitely.
Elder Scrolls 6, Starfield, things we knew.
No. Pause. Okay. So, what did you think about the conference in general?
Oh, it dragged on so long. How it just dragged on so long.
Yeah, but at least there was a lot of funny bits in between it, though, that helped.
Yeah, no, definitely, like, I feel like at least they tried keeping it entertaining with the concert and the ads and whatnot.
Yeah, the fact that they talked about the people who worked there, that was nice. The joke about Walmart. The band. That the best part of the entire show, maybe all of E3, had to have been the Elder Scrolls with the fridge and all that.
Oh, I thought it was Todd, yeah.
I thought it was Todd. For that one guy, it probably definitely was Todd.
Oh, yeah. Yep, that's good.
Yeah, no, I definitely did enjoy it. Like you said, it did seem like it dragged on again, especially the Fallout one. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love Fallout, so it was nice, but Especially on this day when there was a lot more conferences.
No, I'm just glad that they didn't show a whole bunch of building. Then I would have probably passed out.
Watch as we build... What?
I'm gonna build a skyscraper. Look, guys, I built a whole freaking town. Oh.
All right. So
I'm
what,
going back to bed.
So what about the games?
Dang, Quake definitely excited me for the fact that it's like Fallout.
Unreal.
For the fact that it's like Unreal and, you know, those types of games. Like Paladins and whatnot.
Yeah.
There's not really much else. I mean, I liked the fact of that Wolfenstein.
Yeah, the Wolfenstein co-op. I mean, I know you watched a little bit of the Wolfenstein game, and you were like, this looks like it could be fun.
Yeah,
but we really
fun.
Haven't gotten around to it yet.
There's a lot of things we haven't
There
gotten
is
around
a lot
to.
Of things.
300
and, plus things.
Huh. And obviously Fallout.
Yeah, no, Fallout was good. Doom. Very happy about Doom. Iffy about Prey. Fallout, obviously.
Rage.
Rage, I am curious about. We really need to play the first one. But, I mean, for the most part, I don't think it was as many games as I liked for the Microsoft conference.
Yeah.
But what games I did like, or might like, they looked amazing.
Yeah.
So how about a rating, then?
I'll give it an 8.
I was thinking that too, actually. I was thinking a 7 or an 8. I will go with an 8 because mostly, like I said, there were at least a few good games.
They kept it entertaining.
They kept it entertaining. And for me, it was the guy who yelled I was here for... No. No. It was definitely the...
And then he spent his panties. No one brought.
I'd love to see that. But it was definitely the joke about keeping high or low prices and not keeping secrets. That was a good joke. That because that one right there really said that we're going to try to be good. And then the Fallout or the Elder Scrolls Very Special Edition, for me, just really sold the show along with the good game. So, yeah, no, I definitely think an 8. Obviously better than EA. Unravel 2, but... I definitely like Bethesda more, because, again, EA was mostly sports.
Ew.
Microsoft. I mean, I know, obviously, we rate this higher than Microsoft.
You mean EA?
Well, we rated it...
Microsoft, we rated higher than EA.
Yeah, but we rated this higher than Microsoft.
So, pretty much, this is rated everything.
Yeah. So, but... I want to say that Bethesda's done the best so far... But I feel like there's more games for the Xbox that I want. So it's kind of a tie right now between Bethesda and Microsoft. But I think for me, EA is definitely at the bottom with just the few games that they did have.
Nope. Microsoft gonna be staying at a, what did I put it, a 5?
No. I think a 6, I think.
Oh, yeah, I put it at 6. Yeah, it's still below it for me. I don't think they're tied.
No, for separate shows, definitely. For separate shows, Microsoft definitely didn't do as good as Bethesda. But like I said, I've got to put into account that I feel like there's more games that I wanted for it.
Yeah, but that could be for both of them.
That could
be.
Well, I mean, Todd's been at 3 conferences now.
At least Bethesda actually, like, shown some things, though.
They did. Microsoft was a lot more trailers.
They put so much effort into it, especially the Fallout.
Well, not just that, but like the special parts too, like in Prey, when that mimic popped up,
exactly.
And then afterwards they tried to make fun. They really did try to put a lot of entertainment and acting in it, and for that retrospect, they definitely do win as the first right now.
Yeah.
But like I said, because of the games, I'm kind of iffy on which one. But I mean, if we're going by that route, EA at least showed up off some Unravel 2, which they didn't even need to, because they're basically saying, hey, it's free today.
Yeah.
Was enough incentive. All right, so, though, if we're going by rankings, it does seem like Bethesda is winning so far. So, I don't know what conference is next. I want to say it's Square Enix. Let me look this up quickly.
That's the order we want it in.
Yeah, let's see.
I believe it's Square Enix. And that one is boring as hell.
But at least it's short.
Short, boring as hell.
Now, let me say something about the Square Enix one, though. I was so looking forward to it because they have a lot of good games.
And it blew.
That, yeah, pretty much. That are either coming out this year or next year. And they're like, hey, we're going to do a conference during E3. And then really, it still wasn't a conference. And I think that's what really hurt.
And any good games that they had already been shown.
At other conferences.
Yep.
Oh, nope. It's an even shorter one. Our next conference is Devolver Digital.
Oh, no, not that thing.
22 minutes of pure chaos.
Yay.
We'll get into that for the next episode. But then it's Square Enix. Then it's Ubisoft. That one that we didn't see. PC Gaming. And then Sony. And then Nintendo. So yeah, Devolver Digital, you guys are in for a treat next time. I will say that. Because, if anything, I think they really did put a lot of effort into it.
Too much.
Maybe. But we'll go ahead and save that for the next episode. So until next time, remember, keep gaming, never give up, and,
Fallout 76.
Fallout 76.
West Virginia.
Country Mama.
Country Mama.
Country Mama. I'm going Country Mama.